Everything is theoretically impossible until it is done. Hi everyone, myself Palak Raj and I am here with my chemistry experiment. Before starting this experiment, I would like to thank Ms. Kumud whose insightful leadership and knowledge helped me to complete this experiment successfully. I would also like to thank everyone who is involved in this experiment directly or indirectly. I am going to show the reaction of magnesium granules with hydrochloric acid and I will also test the evolution of hydrogen gas. So for this experiment we need hydrochloric acid, magnesium granules, test tube, dropper, forceps, matchbox, and gloves for safety. We will take the test tube and put the magnesium granules inside it. Now with the help of dropper, we will put the hydrochloric acid inside the test tube. When hydrochloric acid is added to magnesium, magnesium chloride is formed. We can see the bubble forming and vapors also, which indicates that a gas is being evolved. Now, we have studied that this gas is hydrogen and we have also studied that hydrogen burns with a pop sound. So, let's test that. When the burning matchstick was brought near test tube, it burned with a pop sound and hence it is proved that the evolved gas is hydrogen. Thank you.
Hello everyone, respected principal, teachers, judges and all my dear friends. I am Payal Shravasav from class 10C, roll number 32 and I am here to present in front of you all a very simple model illustrating multiple reflections of light. What is the meaning of multiple reflections of light? Multiple reflections of light means reflection of a single object and in different mirrors at different angles. This happens because one incident ray from one mirror can act as a reflected ray on the other mirror. Hence, various images are produced. In our previous classes, we have learned the formula for finding the number of images formed when the mirrors are inclined at a specific angle. For example, if the mirrors are placed at an angle theta, then the number of images formed will be 360 degrees by theta minus 1. For example, the angle of the mirrors is 90 degrees. Hence, the number of images formed will be 360 by theta minus 1. That means 360 by 90 minus 1, that is equal to 3. Let us take another example. If the angle is at 180 degrees, then the number of images formed will be 360 by 180 minus 1. That means only one object, one image will be formed of the object. Let us try to demonstrate it practically. First of all, in this you need two mirrors and we need to place them at a straight angle. That means an angle of 180 degrees like this. We are placing the mirrors like this and placing the object in front of it. And we are finding that the number of images formed is only one according to the formula we used to find it out. Now, we are going to change the angle of the mirrors to the 90 degree, like this. And if we put the image in front of it, we are going to find that the number of images is only 3 as we used to find in the formula. You can see that the number of images formed is 3 as it is shown clearly. Hence, we have demonstrated the formula very correct and this is only known as law of multiple reflections of light. It is used in various practical uses and experiments. That's all from my side. Thank you for watching me so patiently. Please forgive my mistakes if any and have a nice day ahead. Thank you.
Lungs in front of you all. So without wasting much of your time, let's get started. As we all know, Inhalation and exhalation of air is a very important function performed by all the living organisms to live. The air that we inhale from our surroundings passes through the nasal cavity through nose, where the dust particles are separated with the help of nasal hair and mucus. The air from the nasal cavity further passes to pharynx and then to the trachea. The trachea does not collapse even when there is no air in it. This is because it is supported by rings of soft bones called cartilage. The upper end of trachea has a voice box called larynx. The lungs are covered by two thin membranes called pleura. The lower end of trachea is further divided into bronchi. The bronchi in the lungs further divides to form large number of still smaller tubes called bronchioles. Each bronchiolus has a tiny air sac at their ends called alveoli. It is in the alveoli that gaseous exchange takes place. Alveoli provides oxygen to the pulmonary veins, which then takes oxygenated blood to the heart. In turn, pulmonary artery provides carbon dioxide to alveoli. The carbon dioxide then passes out of our body with the same process. Thank you.
Judges, my chemistry teacher Ms. Kumud, and all my dear friends present here. I am Priyanka Singh, student of class 10C. Here I am going to show you all what will happen when natural indicator turmeric will add it to acid and base. The materials which are taken for this activity are turmeric solution as an indicator, lemon juice as an acid, and soap solution as a base. Now I'll explain what is an indicator. An indicator is a substance which changes color when added to acid and a base. Now let's proceed. Here I am having lemon juice solution which is an acid, and here I am having soap solution which is an base. Now with the help of dropper, I pour few drops of turmeric solution first in acidic solution bowl and then in basic solution bowl. We can clearly see the color change in both the bowls. In acidic solution, it doesn't show any change. It remains yellow only, but in basic solution, we can clearly see the change in color, which is reddish orange. This is because turmeric is an indicator which doesn't show any change when it's added to acid, but shows change when added to base. Now, with the help of water, we'll clean the dropper. Now the dropper is ready, and from the another bowl of lemon juice, I'll take few drops of lemon juice in the dropper and pour it into the solution of soap and turmeric. Also, I'll mix it well. And we can observe that it changes its color from reddish orange to yellow again. This is because neutralization reaction has taken place. When lemon juice, which is an acid, is added to soap solution, which is a base, and equal amount of acid when added to equal amount of base has neutralized the effect and the solution has become neutral. Now with these observations, I am ending my activity now. Thank you.
Good afternoon, respected principal, vice principal, judges, teachers and my fellow classmates. I am Rachna Garg and I am going to show you all refraction of light using a glass slab. My experiment is from my science book 10th chapter, light reflection and refraction. Let's know what is refraction of light. The bending of light from one medium to another medium is known as refraction of light. Here, the first medium is air and the second medium is this glass slab. First, I will make the outlines of this glass slab. I will make an incident ray here. And now, I will put some pins on it. This side, I will see the previous pins from here and then I will try to fix the another pins here so that those previous pins and these pins are in a straight line. You can see I have fixed the pins, and now I will remove this glass lamp and then mark the points where I have kept these pins. Now after removing those pins, I will make normal for these lines. Now after making the normals for these two lines, we will join these two lines. So we can see that the ray of light coming from the air to this glass slab is bending towards this normal. And when it is coming out from the glass slab to the air, it is bending away from the normal. This is what we call as refraction of light. Thank you for watching.
Hey, have you ever thought why do we immediately remove our hand from any harmful stuff? That may be a hot stove or a candle, even before a message goes to our brain. Well, all this happens due to reflex actions. What are reflex actions? Well, reflex actions can be defined as automatic and involuntary responses to the sensory stimulus which is not under conscious control. In reflex actions, the path followed by the message is known as the reflex arc, which will be further explained by the model which I have prepared. So now, before entering into this sci-fi world, let me introduce myself. Hello everyone, this is Rashi Ranjan, a student of class 10C, and it is a great honor for me to be present here. Also, before starting, I would like to thank all our teachers for their extraordinary efforts during this time of the COVID pandemic. So now, let us move to the explanation of reflex arc.
Any hot object, for example a hot tumbler or a candle, the pain-sensitive receptor cells present in the fingertips detect the heat stimulus and trigger the nerve impulses. These impulses then travel along with the sensory nerve to the spinal cord. The sensory neurons then send electrical impulses to the relay neuron, which is located in the CNS of the spinal cord. The relay neuron gets stimulated and makes a contact with the motor neuron. The motor neuron sends a signal to the effector. The effector produces an instantaneous response, which in this case will be the movement of hand away from the tumbler. Well, that was all from my side. Thank you for listening. Thank you very much.
Hello everyone. This is Ruchika of class 10. The purpose behind this video is to show air also exerts pressure on liquid. Now let's talk about that material we required for this experiment. Material that we required are a glass, plastic bottle, a balloon, and a straw. Let's start with the experiment. First we will make a hole here in the bottle. As you can see, we have made hole here. Now we will put the straw in this hole, like this. Now we will pour water in this bottle, like this. Now we will inflate this balloon. Now we will fix this balloon on the top of this bottle like this. Now we will deflate this balloon. As you can see, in due to air released by the balloon, water in the bottle passes through the pipe into and it is collected into the another container. Hence we conclude that air exerts pressure on the liquid.
Hello everyone, I am Sakshi Premada and I am here with my model on human respiratory system. In this model, I have used cardboard, some colorful papers, straws and two balloons. To understand what is respiration, the process by which living being utilizes the food to get energy is called respiration. Respiration is an oxidation reaction in which carbohydrates is oxidized to get energy.
Mitochondria is the site of respiration and the energy released is stored in the form of ATP. ATP is stored in mitochondria and is released as per need. Steps of respiration. First, breaking down of glucose into pyruvate. This step happens in the cytoplasm. Glucose molecule is broken down into pyruvic acid. Glucose molecule is composed of 6 carbon atoms while pyruvic acid is composed of 3 carbon atoms. Number 2. Fate of pyruvic acid. Further breaking down of pyruvic acid takes place in mitochondria and the molecules formed depend on the type of respiration in a particular organism. Respiration is of 2 types, that are aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Number 3. Respiration involves gases exchange, that is intake of oxygen from the atmosphere and release of carbon dioxide, known as breathing. Breaking down of simple food in order to release energy inside the cell, known as cellular respiration. Now, coming to aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration is a type of respiration happens in the presence of oxygen. Pyruvic acid is converted into carbon dioxide. Energy is released and water molecule is also formed at the end of this process. Anaerobic respiration. This type of respiration happens in the absence of oxygen. Pyruvic acid is either converted into ethyl alcohol or lactic acid. Ethyl alcohol is usually formed in case of anaerobic respiration in microbes like yeast or bacteria. Lactic acid is formed in some microbes as well as in muscle cells. At last, I would like to conclude with the human respiratory system is composed of a pair of lungs. These are attached to the system of tubes which open on the outside through the nostrils.
So, that's all from my side. I hope you liked it. Thank you and have a nice day.
This is Sangam Pandey from 10C and I am here to show you an experiment on effects of litmus paper on acid, base and neutral substance. First of all, what is an indicator? An indicator is a substance which tells us whether the substance we are testing is an acid or base by change in its color. Material required for this experiment: sodium bicarbonate solution, toilet cleaner solution, water and litmus paper. Procedure of this experiment is, when we will put this litmus paper in sodium bicarbonate solution, it will remain as blue. But if we will put this blue litmus paper in toilet cleaner solution, it will turn into red. As you can see, when if we will put this red litmus paper in sodium bicarbonate solution, it will turn into blue. If we will take this blue litmus paper and put it into water, it will remain as blue. And if we will take this red litmus paper and put it into water, it will remain as red. Blue litmus paper remains as blue. Red litmus paper turns into blue in sodium bicarbonate solution. Red litmus paper remains as red and blue litmus paper turns into red in toilet cleaner solution. Blue litmus paper remains as blue and red litmus paper remains as red in water. So, we can conclude that sodium bicarbonate is basic in nature, toilet cleaner is acidic in nature, water is neutral in nature. Now, I would like to thank all of you and I hope that you all liked it. Thank you.